Can we compute the inverse of every matrix? How can we compute the inverse of every matrix? Why would we so? What's the use of an inverse? Well, quite a lot of questions, and all of them will be answered in one web lecture. Well, as far as the 2x2 case is concerned. However, the 2x2 case already gives us an idea for the general case, so it's a good starting point. So, can we find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix A? Let us call A ABCD, so some general matrix A. So, if the inverse exists, A inverse, then it will be also 2x2 matrix. So, A inverse has to be EFGH. And if it exists, then A times A inverse, A times A inverse has to be the identity matrix. So, given A, B, C, and D, can I find EF, G, and H? Well, just multiply it out. So, use the row column rule over here. So, we get A times E plus B times G. And here, with this one and this one, we get C times E plus D times G. And then we continue. A times F plus B times H, and then C times F plus D times H. So we get two matrices over here, 2x2 matrix and 2x2 matrix. And those two matrices are the same, even only if the other elements are the same. So what we get is a linear system of four equations with four unknowns. There's no A, B, and C, and D are known. The unknowns here are E, F, G, and H. And for example, AB plus BG has to be equal to 1, and CE plus DG has to be equal to 0. Fortunately, our system of four equations and four unknowns split into two systems of two equations and two unknowns, because the E and the G only are over there, and the unknowns F and H are only over there. So I can first solve for E and G, and then do the same trick, solve for F and H. So let's try to solve for them. A times E plus B times G equals 1, C times E plus D times G equals 0. What you can do, for example, you multiply the first equation by the D, and you multiply the second equation by B, and then you can subtract in this way, so you get the D over here as well. Then you get and the D's and the B's over there. Then you get AED minus CEB equals 1. And you can solve for E equals D over AD minus BC. And you can do something similar for G. You can solve for similar G as well. G equals minus C over AD minus BC. And do the same trick for F and H. And in this way you can find a formula for the inverse. You call this quantity AD minus BC, which occurs everywhere. You call that the determinant of A. Later on we'll see much more about determinants of matrices. For now, for 2x2 matrix, the determinant is just A times C minus B times C, which is number. And then your A inverse, you have to divide by the determinant. And here you get the D and the C as we already saw. And for the other terms, you get the minus B and H. So, can you always find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix? Well, only if AD minus BC is non-zero. If it is non-zero, then you have the formula, you know your inverse. If it is zero, you know that you cannot find an inverse. So let's look at two examples. A equals 1, 2, 3, 4, then A inverse. Well, first compute the determinant. 1 times 4 minus 2 times 3. 4 minus 6 equals minus 2, so non-zero. So inverse, A inverse equals 1 over minus 2. And then you interchange the 1 and the 4 and put minuses over here. So you get the 4, 1, minus 3, minus 2. And there you have your A inverse. If you have the matrix B, 1, 2, 2, 4, which is almost the same, determinant equals 1 times 4 minus 2 times 2, 4 minus 4 equals 0, which means that the inverse does not exist. Then let's look at one application. x1 plus 2 times x2 equals 5, and 3 times x1 plus 4 times x2. 2 equals 6 in our system, two equations, two unknowns. Of course, we know how to do that. We can use row reduction, but we can also do it another way. Now we have the inverse of a matrix A. because you see you can write this linear system as a vector equation and then as a matrix equation, A times x equals b. And this A happens to be exactly the same as this A we had over here, from which we already know the inverse. And now we can use this inverse because we can multiply our equation x equals b on the left. Always be aware you have to multiply on the same side of an equation if you do matrix multiplication, because it does not commute. We multiply on the left by A inverse and we get A inverse times A times x equals A inverse times b. Well, A inverse times A equals the identity matrix, so we get identity matrix times x equals A inverse times b. Identity matrix times x is just x, so x equals A inverse times b. So with this trick we can immediately find our x. X equals the A inverse times b equals minus 1/2 times 4 times 5 equals 20 minus 12 equals 8 times minus 1/2 equals minus 4. And the other term minus 15 plus 6 equals minus 9 times minus 1/2 equals 4.5. So there you have immediately your x. So now you know how you can compute matrix of the inverse of a 2x2 matrix, when you can compute it, and how you can use it to solve, for example, a linear system.